Every curious mind has lots of unanswered questions about our universe and celestial bodies. So, let's begin the question answer session.
Sir, what is the speed of light?
It's approximately 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second.
Sir, if we are able to travel faster than the speed of the light, then would we be able to travel back in time?
Notionally, yes. But you need to understand a lot more of physics for that before you can...
But it's practically impossible.
Yes. That's right. Yeah. Yes. Once again, the arrow of time can be reversed only when you go from one place to another place, you can reach there. But that's not quite the same as saying that I'll sit here and go back into my past in the same location. The two are separate statements.
In fact, it's not simply a practical matter either. Even by way of the theoretical construct, it's not possible. Nothing is allowed to go faster than the speed of light. Okay, so even as a theoretical matter, it's simply not possible. Never mind practical.
So if we somehow do manage to go faster than the speed of light, will when we go by a big object, will it deflect us? Because normally light is attracted, but if we go faster than the speed of light, will we be deflected by it?
The first thing you have to do before you do any such thing is to rework your entire theoretical framework to understand how anything will happen. No, that apart, I don't think we know anything about what happens if we go farther. We have no idea what will happen if it goes faster than the speed of light. Yeah.
I heard somewhere that when two very large mass, two objects having a large mass are falling into each other, they first circulate around each other. So if one is of 25x mass and one is of 36x mass, so when they collapse, the new mass that is formed is much lesser than their total addition. So why does that?
Energy is liberated. Energy and mass are equivalent. So, from a conceptual point of view, that's it. I mean, there's some energy liberated. I mean, and of course, it's not as if this, E equals mc squared. I mean, as in the energy that's liberated is all the rest mass is completely, no. The efficiency is pretty small. But it can happen that the new object that's formed is of a smaller mass than the sum of the masses of its parent bodies. The difference will be liberated in some kind of energy. The details are quite complex and